Hey guys, it's Dave from Wellsby Roots, and today I want to cover your vehicle emergency kit. I just want to say right off the hop that you do not have to have these type of cases. Any storage case, whether it be Rubbermaid, whether it be, you know, old milk crates, whatever it is that you're going to store your stuff in, it doesn't matter. I bought these because they're heavy duty and because I like the fact that everything was, you know, kept nice and neat. So you don't have to go this route. Just whatever you're going to store is the items that are important, obviously. So here are a few of the items that I carry in the vehicle all year round. And when I say all year round, it's because some of the items get switched out depending on the time of year. I live in Canada, so in the wintertime it gets extremely cold. I'm going to quickly go through these items and then we'll move on to the next ones. So let's look at simple items like this. Here's a pen and a pad of paper. The reason for it is because you never know when you need to write a note. And in case of an emergency where you needed to leave your vehicle, which is not recommended, it's always recommended to stay with your vehicle just because it's such a large landmark of where you are. And more than likely, if you're with your vehicle, then you're on a path that is traveled by other people. So it's always recommended to stay with your vehicle, but in some sort of circumstance where you needed to leave, it's super intelligent to leave a note stating what time you left and what direction you're heading and where it is exactly that you plan to go. So notepad and a paper or a pen. I would even recommend, instead of a pen, actually having a pencil. Just because in extreme cold situations, the pen might freeze up, the ink might freeze up, and it no longer works. So in reality, I would suggest having a pencil instead of a pen. Gloves. Gloves are always a good thing to have in an emergency kit, just because they help protect your hands. Say you got to change a tire, you got to work on something in the vehicle, and or you just need to be outside in the extreme cold. It's always good to have some gloves, some work gloves, something to use to protect your hands. So this is more for winter use. Here is a snow brush. It's just a cheapy snow brush. I think it was like $5 at Canadian Tire. It's made out of wood, nothing fancy, but it works and it does the job. This is extremely important in cold climate weather. You need to have one of these with you. Tire iron. You need one of these in order to change a tire. If you do not know how to change a tire, I would suggest you stop this video and go watch a video on how to change a tire and learn how to change the tires in your car. It's super simple. It's not complicated. And once you know how to do it, you'll be amazed and you'll be wondering why you never knew before. So tire iron always comes in handy if changing the tire. Also, you can use it as a pry bar and a crowbar. Extreme circumstances, you could use it for self-defense. So, flashlight. I use a rechargeable flashlight. That way, I know it always has power. And this particular brand, I have a video on it, and I will try and remember to leave a link. But this particular brand has a solar panel, but it also has an internal battery. And I've had this for probably 10 years, and it still works today. It's never failed me. It's fairly bright, and like I said, charges off of solar, and then it has an internal battery as well. So safety glasses protect your eyes. End of story. Protects your eyes. Map. I carry a map in my vehicle because electronics fail. So whether you have a GPS or whether you have a cell phone, electronics still have a tendency to fail. And having a paper map and knowing how to use it is extremely important. And this won't fail you. So You'll have this with you and you'll be able to navigate. Bungee cords, always a good thing to have. Strapping things down, keeping things tight. Bungee cords, I think they basically speak for themselves. So I always have bungee cords and I have them kind of tucked in here typically. So they're close at hand and I can get to them quickly. With today's society, or the events that are occurring today, having some masks, whether they be, you know, typical hospital type masks, whether they be N95 masks, you know, or N95 mask with the breathing valves a little bit more, this is a little bit more advanced. The mask actually straps around your neck and won't let loose. In today's world, it's important to have masks. So I included them into this video because it's an important thing to have. So I have an abundance of masks, different types, you know, some quickie, cheapy ones that, you know, really don't do anything except, you know, make other people feel good. And gloves. Now I have these black latex gloves and they're fine and dandy. But if you need to, if you needed to work on somebody, for instance, that was bleeding, the black latex aren't the best bet just because of the fact that you can't tell that there's blood on the gloves. So according to some medics, it's better to have blue gloves, because you'll be able to see the blood on the gloves and you'll be able to avoid it yourself. With these ones, you're not going to see the blood on the gloves and you're not going to be able to avoid it yourselves. I mean, obviously, if you're wearing these gloves, you can still be careful. I have an abundance of these black latex gloves, so I do use them. But if you needed to work with blood, whether someone's bleeding or whether you're bleeding, you're not going to be able to see the blood on the black latex. You'll only be able to see them on the blue. So, but latex gloves are important to have. Protect yourself. Jumping back and forth because these are items that I just had randomly in my glove box and kind of throughout the car. So this isn't in any particular order. This is called a cheater hose, or at least that's what I call it. Basically what it is one end hooks up to one tire. And the other end hooks up to the flat tire. And what's going to happen is the weight of the car is going to push the air from the full tire through to the flat tire. And you'll be able to get that tire up enough that hopefully you'll be able to make it to some sort of station, whether it be a gas station or whatever else. You'll be able to get to a pump where you can repair that tire. So, or blow it up the rest of the way. So for whatever reason it went flat, you should also have a repair kit in your vehicle. And again, know how to use it in case you do get a puncture in your one of your tires and then you can fix it yourself. So this is a cheater hose. Thermal blanket. This is reusable. I do not like the silver ones that are like, you know, they're only like this big, like just, they're like, you know, 2 inch by 4 inch or something along those lines. Once you unwrap them, they're useless. They're a one-time use blanket. Yes, this is a little bit bigger, but you can continuously use this over and over and over again as long as the blanket lasts. I have another one of these blankets and they are quite durable. They're quite strong. They stand up. They're reinforced along the edges. They're just a good blanket to have. I bought this off of Amazon. So it's a good blanket to have, something to help keep you warm in the car, in case, you know, again, the vehicle breaks down and you're stuck out in the wintertime. Disinfectant wipes. They disinfect. So this will help keep your car clean, help keep you clean, your cans clean. I wouldn't use them on my face, but, you know, each their own. So disinfectant wipes, an important item to have in the vehicle. Hand sanitizer, another important item to have in a vehicle, especially today with the events that are taking place. Hand sanitizer is always a good thing to have in your vehicle. Umbrella. Seems simple enough, but a lot of people forget to bring their umbrellas, and umbrella is a good thing to have in case it rains. So this is an eliminator. So what this does is it charges your battery. So if your battery goes dead, basically you plug this into your car cigarette outlet. I don't know if that's what they call them anymore. Most vehicles today don't have the old school push cigarette lighter. But anyway, so you plug this into your vehicle cigarette lighter and it charges your battery. And you can also use it as a 12-volt adapter as well. 12-volt adapter. So you plug this into your 12-volt adapter and it charges your battery. But you can use this as well, plug things into it, and and charge those items up as well. This one's really old. Some of the newer ones have like USB ports and stuff like that. These are a good thing to have in your vehicle. So now with that said, I do carry jumper cables, and I'll show you them in a minute when I get to the tool section. Jumper cables are absolute must to have in your vehicle. I don't care if you have one of these. Must have jumper cables in your vehicle. Whether you're a good Samaritan or whether you break down and something's wrong with this, if you don't have jumper cables, the guy who comes to help you may not have jumper cables either. So I actually came across that situation where a guy needed help and he had no jumper cables. Luckily I did, so I was able to help him out anyway. So jumper cables and these eliminators are an excellent item to have in your vehicle. Next up, traction. So whether you carry cat litter, which I've never really found to be all that helpful, or whether you carry plastic tracks, these tracks, I don't know if you can still get them. These are really old. I think I have seen them online. But these are steel. These are solid steel tracks. They have come in, like they have saved me, I don't know how many times, countless times. I've lost count how many times that I've had to use these, especially out here in the country. So our vehicle is kind of a city-ate vehicle, because we come from the city. So I haven't had the finances to buy the vehicle that I'd like to purchase. One day that will happen. But in the meantime, I'm stuck with this city-ate vehicle, and we get stuck a lot out here in the country where we get a lot of snow drifts. So despite the snow fences that we put up. But tractions are an absolute must. Have them in your vehicle, and you can always help someone else out as well. So this is wiper fluid. I know this might seem silly, but I always keep a jug of wiper fluid in my vehicle because it happens when you just run out of wiper fluid. Happens all the time, and if you're not paying attention. So it makes it difficult to drive if you can't see through your windshield. So I always keep wiper fluid in my vehicle, and I have I always buy the minus 90 or minus 49 to minus 50 wiper fluid, regardless if it's summertime or not, just because it's always in there. And if you get frost or if it gets cold, that stuff really comes in handy when it won't freeze up, you know. So you got to remember, it might only be negative 10 out, but when you're driving, that windshield effect is the wind is blowing at your vehicle, and it's a lot colder than minus 10 when that's going on. So having negative 49 to negative 50 windshield wiper fluid is a good idea. So I also keep some extra, these aren't blankets. These are like picnic blankets. So they're water resistant on one side, and then they have, you know, fuzzy fabric on the other side. They're just nice to sit on sometimes if the surface is wet. So sometimes I'll put these on the porch if it's rained or whatever else. I want to sit on the porch. It's just nice padding, basically. So under here in my vehicle, this is where I keep a lot of the tools. So you can see you got some screwdrivers, like flats, and you got some ratchet straps for tightening things down. You got some adjustable wrenches and some vice grips, Allen keys, duct tape, lots of gloves. I like gloves. There's a small that's a roadside kit, small roadside kit. I'm a big believer in, I'm a big believer in two is one and one is none. If you have two of something and you lose one, then you still have one. If you have one and you lose it, then you have nothing. So, you know, two is one, one is none. Here are the jumper cables I was talking about. So, like I said, I always have jumper cables. There's another pry bar. You should always have jumper cables with you, regardless of whether or not you have a battery charger of some sort. They're just handy to have. Plus, in a survival situation, you can use your jumper cables, hook up to your battery, and use them in combination with steel wool or maybe aluminum gum wrapper, something along those lines. And it will actually ignite and start a little fire. It will be your ignition source anyway for making an actual fire. So underneath this is my spare tire, which you should always try to have a spare tire with you if you can. A full-size spare tire is the best. Unfortunately, this vehicle, they did not give us the space for a full-size spare tire. So under here, under these adjustables and vice grips, is actually a tire repair kit. Learn how to use one of these and keep one with you. And if you need to repair your tire, if you get a puncture, this kit will patch that puncture permanently. So, or semi-permanently. But they're a good kit to have and a good thing to learn how to use. So this is just an example of a flat tire that I have in my truck. Sometimes when the weather changes, the tire goes flat. But what I want to show you here is what I call a cheater hose. So it's just a transfer hose. So what I'm going to do is you could hook this up to the truck tire and then hook it up to a rear tire and help inflate this tire. But I'm not going to do that today because I'm going into town with the other vehicle. So today what we're going to do is we're going to hook it up like so. Then we're going to go over here to this other vehicle. It's hard to do this one-handed. There we go. And the weight of the vehicle is going to press down this tire and force the air into this tire, hopefully help inflate it. Now I'm not going to use this tire alone off the other vehicle. In a few minutes I'll switch to a back tire. And then like I said, I'm going into town, so at that point I'll pump both these tires back up. But I need to get some air into these tires. So you can see the tire is not 100% inflated, but you can see this wet line, that's where it was sitting on the ground. And by using the cheater hose, like I said, I was able to get the tire up. It's up enough now that the tire or the vehicle is drivable, so I could get it to a station and get it pumped up the rest of the way if that's what I needed to do. So just a short video. Giving you a tip on one of these emergency cheater hoses or transfer hoses so that you can get from A to B in the case of an emergency. Thanks for watching, guys. Catch you on the next one. So, winter's coming, and I know you see all this snow on the ground. This is nothing. This is just This is Mother Nature reminding us that winter is coming, because this is nothing. So it's time to go through the emergency preps and change out some things. Really, with the emergency preps that I carry, the only things that I'm going to change out are my water supply. When the temperature drops a little bit lower, I'm going to get rid of the water because it's going to freeze up and it will be useless anyway. So when winter is here, this is all the water we need. So I just want to point out that typically during three seasons out of the year, I do carry water. So I carry this is a green plastic, looks like a jerry can, but it's just water. So it's been purified with bleach. So it's good to go. It will go in the house and it will go into the pantry, and it would just be some more water to have on hand, as well as the water that I carry in here. I carry a lot of water because, especially during the summer months, as cold as it gets here during the summer months, it gets hot. So water is good. It's good to drink. It's good to cool down with. Wash your hands. If you had, say, a radiator leak, you could put it in there temporarily. I say temporarily because if you had a rad leak and you need to use water, it's fine for the hot months or a temporary fix until you can get your rad fixed and get to a mechanic. But during the cooler months, it's no good. You'll end up destroying your radiator altogether. So in here I do carry some more water. So I got some water bottles,
just for the kids. Just, you know, quickly drink out of these. It's convenient, I guess. So I got a couple of water bottles. And then I got some water jugs. These are 4-liter jugs. And you can see, as cold as it is right now, these are not frozen. So they'll stay in the kit for, you know, I don't know, a couple more weeks. And then I'll take them out when the temperatures start to drop well below zero. It's about -10 right now, so it's not very cold. So, wool blankets. As you already saw, I carry a emergency blanket that you can wrap around yourself, and it helps radiate heat back to your body. But I also carry wool because I'm a big believer in wool. Even soaking wet, wool will still retain 80% of its heat value. So soaking wet, this blanket will still keep you warm. Steel water jugs, all right? I can't stress how important it is to have steel containers for your water. Just because you can boil your water in here, we can collect snow, we can heat it up, we have drinking water. Anything else just isn't going to cut it. So get rid of the plastic. It's just garbage. Flashlight. I carry a flashlight. It illuminates. So not much more to say than that. You can use a flashlight to flag people down. You use a flashlight to look around. You can use a flashlight for doing repairs, changing a tire. Just lighting up the car. Say you break down, you got your kids, you know, it's pitch black. They're getting a little wigged out by it. Flashlight's going to help illuminate the vehicle, without, carbon monoxide. So it's a good thing to have with you. This one is waterproof, 120 lumens, and it, charges via USB. So it's a good little flashlight. I've tried it out. It's a good little emergency light. Now, even though your kids should be dressed appropriately when you go out of the house, sometimes, you know, I don't know, you might be in a rush. They might throw their hat out the window of the car. You never know. So having spare hats, spare gloves, for whoever's going to be driving with you is always a good idea. Gloves. Now, I already have gloves for working on the vehicle, gloves for keeping your hands, you know, safe. But now it's time to switch over to winter gloves. I still keep those other gloves in the vehicle, but these gloves are going to keep your hands warm. These are 3-finger mittens. So you still have the ability to pull the trigger or work on things, but it helps keep your hands warm if your fingers are together. They're just a good idea. I found they are more helpful, more useful than regular mittens. So it's good leather. So it's just snacks. I got some snacks in the car. These are high energy type snacks. We got some Werther's snacks and some Rice Krispie squares. Just something for, you know, to munch on, to pass the time, give you a little bit of a morale boost. It's not a bad idea. Remember always to, pick the stuff that your family's going to enjoy. So just because I have those type of snacks doesn't mean you got to have those type of snacks. You can have, you know, whatever your family's going to like. So this is just another wool blanket. I have 2 wool blankets in there, just to keep everyone warm. I have a large military type scarf. This would be good for keeping warm and first aid. And I have a wool hat for myself. Now, these were a pair of hiking boots that I had in the vehicle. I might switch these out, or I might keep them in there. I have the space. Just an extra pair of shoes. I always suggest, whether it's summer, spring, fall, or winter, that you have an extra pair of comfortable boots that you can hike in case you do need to leave your vehicle. Again, it's not suggested. An extra hat during the summer months.
just to keep your head protected, keep the weather, the sun off your head. Inside these boots, I have a pair of ice grips. Basically, these slip onto the bottoms of whatever it is you're wearing on your feet, and they will help prevent you from slipping on ice and snow, slippery surfaces. So these nuts here dig in and give you some extra traction. And I just keep these tucked into the boot, and that way they don't get lost. So I got these matching cases. And again, you don't have to get matching cases. You don't have to be fancy dancy. Whatever you can fit stuff into, whatever you can organize with, do it. Dollar store, Tupperware, whatever. It's all good as long as you have the items that you actually need. So in here, I just have a bag. This is just a quick bag that you can just throw some items into, throw it on your back, and off you go. And then inside here are just some fire kits for creating fire. There's different techniques to each kit. There's everything from matches to cut up juice containers, because these slits of the juice containers have wax on them, so they'll burn for a long period of time. There's steel wool in here, which can be used with sparks. The steel wool will actually light up and help you initiate your fire. You can also use a steel wool in combination with your car battery and jumper cables, and that will help you start a fire as well. There's lint in here. There's the pads that women use to wash their faces with. They're cotton pads. They're excellent, especially when you combine them with wax or Vaseline. Some pencils in here, because I like pencils better than pens. They're more reliable. You can use your knife to sharpen them, or you can use a pencil sharpener. And you can also use the shavings to help start a little fire. So a plastic bag, just for, you know, again, odds and ends, carrying stuff, collecting water, so on and so forth. Kind of like a little survival kit, I guess. Very, very, very basic. So the second container, I have a large roll of Gorilla Black duct tape. I got some paracord and some garbage bags. These are industrial garbage bags. They are excellent for, again, storing stuff, keeping stuff from getting soaking wet, making ponchos with. You can, you know, put your kids in a nice wool blanket and then cover them in a garbage bag, cutting out a hole for their heads. And then they have a poncho as well. So keep them warm, keep them dry. Garbage bags, if you Google garbage bags and their uses, you'll come up with a huge list. Duct tape as well. I mean, this stuff is just, it's worth its weight in gold. So, and then paracord. So that is in this kit. So this kit's kind of a mix of things. We have some hand sanitizer here. Obviously, hand sanitizer is good for sanitizing your hands. It will also help ignite a fire if you need to start a fire. We got some earplugs, some tape, electrical tape. This is yellow electrical tape. This would be good for, you know, making things visible, signaling, and then obviously taping things up. Some Vaseline in combination with those cotton pad things that girls use to clean their faces with helps start a fire. We got some cotton here. These are just cotton strips. You can cut it off to length. And I like using these better than Band-Aids. So, well, I have a Band-Aid on my finger, I know. But anyway, you cut these to the size of the cut. And then you use this in combination with tape. And tape up the wound or the cut. There's some ointment in here and some chapstick. All this stuff is good for starting fires as well. So these were just kind of odds and ends that I had laying around. I have a more thorough first aid kit, but these were just little bits that I had. Also in here are some candles, because candles are excellent for, you know, lighting dark places up, but also providing heat.
Again, I will say that if you are using candles or something of that nature, be mindful of carbon monoxide poisoning. So every once in a while, open up a window, let some fresh air in, get the carbon monoxide out. So, but candles are a must have. Some playing cards. My boys are a little too young for this, but playing cards just to keep morale up, depending on how long you're stuck. These, I'm sure you can still get them. I'm not sure 100% where you might get them, but what this is you actually ignite this with a lighter and it burns slowly and you put it into this case. The whole case heats up. It's a hand warmer. So the whole case heats up. You can slip these into your gloves or you can just hold them like this and they'll keep your hands warm. I have a whole package of the inserts for them, as well as an extra lighter. And then I have another one because two is one and one is none. And these are the fuel sticks for these as well. So this is the lantern for these candles. So these lanterns, I have a video on how to make your own candles for these lanterns. These lanterns are worth their weight in gold as well. And then that way too, your candle's not just kind of, you know, floating around where somebody could knock it over or get burnt or get hurt. So that's in that case. So this is a much larger case that fits in there. And here is a more thorough first aid kit. We have some tape, some gauze for taping up wounds, small emergency blanket, keep somebody warm that's injured. We have some alcohol wipes and some latex gloves, some more latex gloves, some scissors. These are simple scissors, they're not very good, but they're scissors, and some alcohol wipes and some more latex gloves, a small knife and survival whistle, some more electrical tape, some painkillers, in here is just a small first aid kit that I had floating around that I decided just to throw in. Now this is another baggie full of bandages and tape, gauze, alcohol wipes, and latex gloves. This is a small little first aid kit that I put together myself. Building these first aid kits yourselves, and there's tons of information online. There's tons of videos on building first aid kits, and there's tons of information, PDFs that you can download off Amazon for building first aid kits. Always cheaper to build your own first aid kit. It's just to buy one that's already pre-made. That's fine and dandy if you have the money to do it. But they're always 10 times more expensive when they're pre-made for you. So if you can, go on to Google, do some research, and create your own list according to your family and your needs, and build your own first aid kit. Some maxi pads, they help stop bleeding. This first aid kit was kind of built on a car emergency type kit, but it was also built because I started hunting and I wanted a trauma kit, which actually turned into this. But I think that we will save this trauma kit for another video, what's actually in here and what a trauma kit actually consists of. So first aid kit basically is the point, is you need to have some sort of first aid kit. Doesn't need to be a trauma kit, but some sort of first aid kit in your vehicle with you. Whether it's for you or whether it may be for someone else that's hurt, it is never a bad thing to have, you know. It's like having car insurance. So here's a screenshot of some of the items again. Oops, forgot to put those bandages in the first aid kit. But just some of the items that I carry for emergencies and some of the ideas of why I carry them. And I'm sure that it's not complete.
I'm sure that as time goes on, I'll learn more and experience more and understand more. And I'm sure after this video gets uploaded, everybody will have some more wisdom to share with the rest of us, which I hope that they do. So, hope you enjoyed this video. And please leave your comments, suggestions, and advice. We are all still learning, and we can learn from each other. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch you on the next one.